Hello and welcome. Weiser Technik have released a new product. What does it do and what problems does it address? Well, simply put, inside this tail unit, if you've got a GS or a GSA, year models 21, 22 or 23, and you've got multifunction indicators, you will probably have already noticed that BMW decided and actively removed the tail light function from within inside there. So that unit only does one thing, which is perform a brake light function. So this is what the little module from Weiser Technik addresses. It's gonna mount underneath the tail unit up here, and at the end of this video, I will have a link to an installation guide and show you how simple and easy it is to install. There's just three wires. It really is a simple job to do. Well, the first thing is, when we look at the rear of this bike, I've returned everything back to original. So these are the original BMW multifunction indicators, which I absolutely dislike. But first, let's turn the ignition on and let's have a look at the problem as it comes from factory. Just bear in mind, if you are in North America, you won't have these multifunction indicators because the DOT didn't approve them, and so BMW weren't allowed to fit them. So you'll have the traditional two LED setup, and inside this tail light, you will still have two functions, tail light and brake light. But for the rest of us, for the global bikes, Australia, Europe, United Kingdom, everywhere else in the world, if you've got multifunction indicators, that tail light function has been switched off. So it's 9:30 at night, it's fairly dark outside, we've got the ignition on, and you can now see on the left and the right hand side on the indicators, we've got the tail light working, but what we don't have is any illumination, any light whatsoever from that center tail lamp assembly. And that's what we want to add from the Weiser Technik module. Now, if we look at BMW's latest S1000 XR, there is no tail lamp assembly. And if we look at the S1000RR, also there's no tail light. All of the rear illumination functions are now being taken care of by these multifunction indicators, which are not very good. And I don't understand why they're doing it, but I think probably with the new GS that's due to come out in September, BMW may well have chosen to remove that tail light. So what we'll do, I'll install the module. It is very easy to do. And then let's have a look and see what the lights are like, because that's an awful lot of illumination we could do with. So we're gonna turn the ignition on and let's have a look. So this is the standard BMW startup sequence with multifunction indicators. But most importantly, now we have tail light illumination present from the tail light with the bike in its normal running mode. So we've now rolled forward in time 2 weeks, so that I've had plenty of time to do testing under different lighting conditions, early in the morning, late at night, during the day, bright sunshine, cloudy days, and in fact rain, to see what this tail light activation really does bring in terms of visibility and safety on the rear. And I'm very pleased with it. But just a couple of things. The clips that we've just watched in the beginning of this episode have all been with the BMW standard multifunction setup, and I wanted to keep those separate so that you could see what it looks like on a standard bike. Now, my bike isn't normally standard. I have these multifunctions which I've got covered up for the moment, but just to be clear, the clips you've just seen have all been the standard bike as you would receive it from the factory. But what we're going to look at from this point on is with the Weiser Technik multifunction indicators. Now, during the development of the run-on module, there were some interesting things that Weiser Technik could do. Now, the first was in terms of light output, the intensity of that tail light. Now, if you take the brake light, for example, and we call that when it's activated, 100% light output, what Weiser Technik ended up deciding on is a light output for this module of about 35%. And they tested different levels, 20, 25, 28, and so on, up and down, until they were happy with the output from the tail light activation module. And I think they've actually got it spot on. I wouldn't actually change anything. They asked me, would I like to make it brighter or duller? And I actually think they've got it spot on. Let's turn the ignition on so that you can have a look. So it's still got the original startup sequence where it applies the brake lights, and then it settles down to just the tail light output. And this is what the module is all about. And even in bright sunshine, we've got blue skies outside, you can still see the output from this tail light. And in a moment, I'm gonna show you a clip that I took last night of this working in the garage in the dark. And at night, this is where it really is very, very noticeable. And I'll just put on some, if I take this off now so you can have a look. So as long as you understand from this point onwards, what we're looking at here are the Weiser Technik multifunction indicators. These replace the BMW ones, which I don't like, and I've explained in another video. But let's just have a look. If I put the indicators on, you can see here what happens with the Weiser Tech units is in the background on the standard bikes you have the tail light still on and then the indicators trying to flash on over the top, whereas you have a little tiny switch inside these modules and you can decide what you have. And I have mine set so that in the background the tail light is deactivated and all that takes place is an indicator, and all of my friends that follow me, because I do quite a bit of touring, find this the most visible way to run with these indicators. Let's just have a look with the brake light. So it still performs its brake light function, so we got brake light on, off, nothing's changed there. It's still the same as it was from factory. But one additional thing, and this is quite important, when you install lights on your modern bikes, you quite often have to have an interface or a controller with the CAN bus system, which is the way the electrical system on the bikes are controlled. But the run-on module from Weiser Technik has a microcontroller built into the circuitry, and so it doesn't need any interface. So it really is, as I've just showed you in those earlier pictures, just three wires that connect to the tail light socket on the back, and then it turns on that tail light. So there's no concern about CAN bus compatibility. It doesn't throw up any error codes or any fault codes. It integrates seamlessly with the bike. So you don't need to do any programming and then have a laptop and set anything up. You just disconnect the battery, install the module, reconnect the battery, and away you go. So I think what we'll do now, we'll play the clip from last night so you can see what it's like in the dark, and this is where it's really very, very noticeable. Startup sequence, brake light applied, then it settles down to the normal running light status. Now, clearly we can see we now have a tail light working, which is brilliant, and it's really obvious what's happening with that tail light, and I'm delighted. This is with the Weiser Technik multifunction indicators installed, which are generally much brighter and much more visible than the standard BMW ones. But either way, what we're looking at is the reactivation of the tail light inside the tail light assembly, and I'm delighted. Let me try and move the camera so that you can see this from the side. The tail light is really quite visible. Let me see if I can move around a bit more. Yep, still very, very visible. It has achieved what they promised, which is the activation of the tail light. And actually, in terms of brightness in the evening and at dusk, it's spot on. Absolutely brilliant. Now you've seen the run-on module installed and working. Price, £79.95, that's UK pounds, and that includes VAT, which I actually think is a very good price. But if you do want a discount, you probably remember what to do. First of all, subscribe to the channel. It's free, it doesn't cost anything, and what that does, by subscribing, watching this video, it lets me and Weiser Technik know that you find these videos about their products useful and informative. And then the second thing is, and this is the important one, is episode 13, this video up here. You don't need to watch the whole thing. The video is about the Weiser Technik multifunction indicators. But importantly, at the end of that video, I show you how to get a discount code that is a unique to you, sent from Weiser Tech to you via email. It's a very easy process. You really don't have to hand over much personal information, which is quite important these days. It's an email address, your name, and the type of bike that you've got. And then they'll send you a code that you can use for the new run-on module, or in fact, for any of their products that they have on their website. Install times. I'm still currently making the installation guide to go alongside this product. That will come up in a couple of weeks, well, probably about 7 days' time. I'm still filming, I've got a little bit more to do. But in terms of times, if you've never done anything like this before and your bike is still original, how it came from the manufacturers when it was new with those multifunction indicators, you need to set aside about half an hour. 30 minutes to 40 minutes is all you're going to need to install the run-on module. But If you've already fitted, as I have, these multifunction indicators, you're going to find that time drops quite quickly. And I would think most of you that have already done this will only need about 20, 25 minutes from start to finish, because you already have experience taking the seats and the grab handles and the panel underneath off. You know how easy it is to do. And then that module installation really is a 10-minute job. Anyway, I hope you found today useful. I'm really delighted with the new product. I'm pleased that they finally got it done. We've been talking about it since August last year. Thank you for your time, and I'll see you soon for the installation guide. Thank you.